The Results-Based Performance Management System, or RBPMS, and the Performance-Based Bonus, or PBB, continue to be as tools used by the Philippine bureaucracy in ensuring the institutionalization of the culture of performance among government agencies and employees. From its inception phase in 2012, the implementation of the RBPMS and PBB has come a long way. It has evolved in systems, validation processes, criteria and conditions, and requirements, among others. Beginning in FY 2017, the requirements for the PBB tightened and the implementation focused on the results that matter to the citizen. In the years of the PBB implementation, a number of performance reforms within the agencies took place. Establishment of a performance monitoring and evaluation system, enhanced key performance indicators, compliance to government-mandated law and standards, transparency and accountability, and improved government services and processes. For the 10th cycle of the PBB, the AO25 Interagency Task Force conducted the following: review of the PBB process and impact evaluation by the Philippine Institute of Development Studies and the FY 2017 Rethinking the PBB. Analysis of the historical compliance of agencies to the PBB requirements, reassessment of the existing PBB criteria and conditions and requirements. In 2017, the AO25 conducted a research on rethinking the PBB. This was an initiative to assess the current PBB implementation. Responding to the issues, proposed changes in the requirements of the PBB were introduced and included in the FY 2018 PBB guidelines. Included are the stricter validation of the AO25 and validating agencies beginning FY 2017 PBB, raising the PBB bar and targets, introduction of streamlining and process improvements and citizen or client satisfaction, and submission of the agency's system of rating and ranking. In 2019 and 2020, PIDS conducted an evaluation of the PBB process and its impact to the agencies and individuals. With these studies, feedback from the agencies on their perception of the PBB were presented to the AO25 Technical Working Group for consideration and review. PIDS also cited their policy recommendations in continuing and improving the PBB implementation. In general, the respondents viewed the PBB positively, and one of the policy recommendations was to continue the implementation but improve its processes. The FY 2021 PBB guidelines is the result of these consolidated studies and research in further improving the implementation of the PBB. Signed on June 3, 2021, here are the provisions under Memorandum Circular No. 2021-1. Objectives of the PBB. The overarching goal of the PBB is to strengthen the effectiveness of the incentive system to help agencies achieve the mission-critical objectives and expected outcomes of the government. The criteria and conditions of the PBB were hence refined in order to simplify the PBB process, particularly the validation of compliance, provide flexibility to the agencies in the implementation of the scheme, reinforce the results focus and their interlinkages, such as budget utilization and physical accomplishment, in assessing the overall performance of agencies, administer a more transparent PBB scoring system, strengthen the role of agencies in ensuring accountability of units or individuals responsible for the criteria and conditions, and facilitate the timely release of incentives to eligible agencies. Now, let's discuss the major changes in the FY 2021 PBB. For FY 2021 PBB, the previous criteria and conditions were modified and some requirements were de-emphasized. The good governance conditions shall no longer be included in the criteria to assess the overall eligibility of the agency for FY 2021 PBB, as well as the STO, GAS, and other cost-cutting requirements. These are now under the agency accountabilities, which will be discussed later. And one major change, the delivery units shall no longer be rated and ranked for the FY 2021 PBB. in relation to the targets in previous PBB cycles. The FY 2021 PBB criteria and conditions shall be categorized according to four dimensions of accountability: performance results, process results, financial results, and citizen or client satisfaction results. The agency accountabilities shall strengthen the oversight functions of the agencies in compliance with the existing government-mandated laws and standards within their agencies, raising the PBB bar in the scoring metrics and individual requirements from satisfactory to very satisfactory rating, tying up the full receipt of the PBB rates to the overall score achieved by the agency, and incentivizing eligible officials and employees, and grant PBB at uniform rates across the agency. The FY 2021 PBB covers all departments, bureaus, offices, and other agencies of the national government, including constitutional commissions, other executive offices, Congress, the judiciary, Office of the Ombudsman, state universities and colleges, government-owned or controlled corporations, local water districts, and local government unit. To be eligible for the grant of the FY 2021 PBB, each agency must satisfy the criteria and conditions under the four dimensions of accountability: performance results, process results, financial results, and citizen or client satisfaction results, and attain a total score of at least 70 points based on the PBB scoring system. Here are the FY 2021 PBB targets, assessment, and scoring system. The scoring system aims to simplify and make the final eligibility assessment more transparent and enable agencies to undertake self-assessment vis-a-vis the criteria and conditions to ascertain if they could qualify for the grant of the FY 2021 PBB. The agency accomplishments for each of the criteria shall be rated using a scale of 1 to 5, where 5 is the highest. Each criterion has an assigned weight, as shown in Table 1. The maximum score that may be obtained by the agency is 100 points. To be eligible for the FY 2021 PBB, the agency must attain a total score of at least 70 points. As can be gleaned in this table, a performance rating of 4 in all criteria will yield a total score of 80 points for the agency. To be able to attain a total score of at least 70 points, the agency should aim for a performance rating of 4 in at least 3 criteria. In such case, while the agency will be eligible, the unit most responsible for the criteria with a performance rating of below 4 will be isolated from the grant of the FY 2021 PBB. There are many score combinations for this rating scale. As you can see in the table, although an agency is eligible for the grant of the PBB, the unit or units most responsible for a performance rating of below 4 will be isolated. In summary, to know if an agency can qualify for the FY 2021 PBB, the agency must attain at least 70 points and achieve a performance rating of 4 in at least 3 criteria. These criteria and conditions for the FY 2021 PBB of the four accountability dimensions are recategorized but are already existing conditions of the PBB. The performance results refer to the accomplishment of the Congress-approved performance targets under the performance-informed budgeting of the FY 2021 General Appropriations Act. This fiscal target is an existing eligibility criterion for SUCs and is only reinstated in the case of the national government agencies. The process results refer to the achievements in ease of doing business or ease of transaction with the agency as a result of streamlining, standardization, such as through the ISO-certified QMS or its equivalent, digitization, and related improvements in the delivery of services. This is an existing criterion for NGAs and the GOCCs covered by the DBM. The financial results refer to the actual spending of the agency's budget allotment vis-a-vis the realization of the committed programs and projects based on the FY 2021 GAA. The disbursements BOR as well is a prevailing common target of all agencies. Another existing criterion for all agencies, the citizen or client satisfaction results, refer to the achievements in satisfying the quality expectations of the transacting pub. The targets under performance results will enable agencies to concentrate their efforts and available resources on their mandates and core functions, as well as ensure delivery of high quality and high impact activities. For NGAs, GOCCs covered by the DBM and SUCs achieve each one of the Congress-approved performance targets under the PIB of the FY 2021 GAA. For GOCCs covered by the RA number 10149, LWDs and LGUs achieve the performance targets based on the interim guidelines on the grant of the PBB issued by their respective oversight agencies. The agency shall upload their quarterly BFARs using the DBM Unified Reporting System, or URS, in a timely manner within 30 days after the end of each quarter. The performance results shall be assessed and scored as follows. Under Rating Scale 1, met less than 80% of performance indicators of the Congress-approved performance targets for FY 2021. Deficiencies due to controllable factors. Under Rating Scale 2, met less than 80% of performance indicators of the Congress-approved performance targets for FY 2021. Deficiencies due to uncontrollable factors. Under Rating Scale 3, met at least 80% of performance indicators of the Congress-approved performance targets for FY 2021. Deficiencies due to controllable factors. Under Rating Scale 4, met at least 80% of performance indicators of the Congress-approved performance targets for FY 2021. Deficiencies due to uncontrollable factors. Under Rating Scale 5, met each one of the Congress-approved performance targets for FY 2021. All performance indicators. For departments or agencies and GOCCs covered by the DBM, the target under process results is a greater ease of transaction of frontline services covering all government to citizens, government to businesses, and government to government transactions. This may be achieved through streamlining, especially of frontline services, standardization of frontline processes, including those implemented at the regional, satellite, and extension offices, digitization, such as by developing electronic or online paperless systems, new service delivery channels, contactless transactions, and other process improvements for faster and more efficient public service delivery. For SUCs, the target is to assure quality of service delivery through ISO-certified QMS or its equivalent certification of frontline services. Agencies should report and provide objectively verifiable evidence of their achievements in ease of doing business or ease of transaction from the perspective of the transacting public, such as the actual reduction in processing time, documentary requirements, transaction costs, and other tangible improvements. Agencies may use the modified form to report their streamlining and digitization accomplishments. The ISO-certified QMS or its equivalent certification for frontline services, service delivery standards manual, and the like may be used as evidence to the standardization achievements of the agency. The process results shall be assessed and scored as follows. For departments or agencies and GOCCs covered by the DBM, under Rating Scale 1, no demonstrated ease of transaction. Under Rating Scale 2, achieved targets to ease transaction, including streamlining, digitization, and standardization only for non-frontline services. Under Rating Scale 3, achieved targets to ease transaction, including streamlining, digitization, and standardization in less than 80% of frontline services. Under Rating Scale 4, achieved targets to ease transaction, including streamlining, digitization, and standardization in at least 80% of frontline services. Under Rating Scale 5, achieved targets to ease transaction, including streamlining, digitization, and standardization in all frontline services. For SUCs, under Rating Scale 1, no demonstrated standardization or quality assurance. Under Rating Scale 2, achieved ISO certification or its equivalent certification only for non-frontline services. Under Rating Scale 3, achieved ISO certification or its equivalent certification for less than 80% of frontline services. On the rating scale 4, achieved ISO certification or its equivalent certification for at least 80% of frontline services. On the rating scale 5, achieved ISO certification or its equivalent certification for all frontline services. For agencies and GOCCs covered by the DBM, attainment of the FY 2021 disbursements BORs. And for SUCs, likewise achieve the FY 2021 disbursements BOR and the FY 2021 earmarked income targets. BOR for GOCCs is computed as follows. Disbursements BOR is equal to the total actual disbursement over the total actual obligations, both net of the procurement service. Agencies with fund transfers, either for operating or program subsidies or both, shall also achieve and report the same disbursements BOR for NGAs for all the subsidy releases for 2021 from the three appropriation sources above. Targets under financial results reflect final payments made from the agency's annual budget allotment to realize their committed programs and projects based on the valid appropriations for FY 2021. Disbursements BOR is equal to the total disbursements, including cash and non-cash, excluding personal services, net of payments made in 2021 for past year's obligations, over the total obligations, excluding personal services, from valid appropriations. Please be reminded that the total disbursements is a net of transfers to the procurement service, the Philippine International Trading Corporation, and other implementing agencies which have not been delivered. The financial results shall be assessed and scored as follows. On the rating scale 1, 1 to 19% disbursements BOR. On the rating scale 2, 20 to 39% disbursements BOR. On the rating scale 3, 40 to 59% disbursements BOR. On the rating scale 4, 60 to 79% disbursements BOR. On the rating scale 5, 80 to 100% disbursements BOR. To determine the effectiveness of streamlining, standardization, digitization, and other process improvements in easing transactions with the public, agencies have been encouraged to embed feedback mechanisms and systematically measure citizen or client satisfaction in the delivery of services since the FY 2018 cycle. Provide evidence on CCSS following Annex 4, Citizen or Client Satisfaction Survey. LWDs and GOCCs covered by RA number 10149 shall report the results of their CCSS or feedback mechanism based on the standard methodology and corresponding questionnaire prescribed by LUA and GCG. The citizen or client satisfaction results shall be assessed and scored as follows. On the rating scale 1, no submission or did not conduct CCSS. On the rating scale 2, low satisfaction rate with unresolved 8888 or CCB complaints. On the rating scale 3, average satisfaction rate with unresolved 8888 or CCB complaints. On the rating scale 4, average satisfaction rate with 100% 8888 or CCB complaints resolved. On the rating scale 5, high satisfaction rate with 100% 8888 or CCB complaints resolved. As mentioned earlier, to sustain the institutionalization of compliance to existing government-mandated laws and standards, agencies and their performance management team shall continue to implement, monitor, and enforce compliance with the following requirements within their agencies. While these conditions are no longer required in determining the overall PBB eligibility of agencies, compliance with these conditions shall be used as the basis in determining the eligibility of responsible units and individuals. Agencies should submit their legal requirements directly to the oversight agencies. How to determine if you are eligible for the grant of FY 2021 PBB? First, your agency must achieve at least 70 points in the PBB criteria and conditions. The agency should achieve a performance rating of 4 in at least 3 criteria. The unit or units most responsible, including its head, for the criteria stated in Section 3.0, with a performance rating of below 4 will be isolated from the grant of the FY 2021 PBB. The unit or units most responsible, including its head, for the non-compliance with the agency accountabilities provided in Section 5.0 will also be isolated from the grant of the FY 2021 PBB. Employees belonging to the first, second, and third levels should receive a rating of at least very satisfactory based on the agency's CSE-approved Strategic Performance Management System or the requirement prescribed by the CESB. Employees who transferred from non-participating government agencies shall be rated where he or she served the longest. Officials and employees who failed to submit the 2020 SALEN or those who are responsible for the review and compliance procedure of SALEN shall not be entitled to the PBB. Officials and employees who failed to liquidate all cash advances received in FY 2021 within the regulatory period shall not be entitled to the PBB. Officials or employees who rendered less than 9 months but a minimum of 3 months of service and with at least a very satisfactory rating shall be entitled to the PBB on a pro rata basis. Eligible agencies shall be granted FY 2021 PBB at uniform rates across the agency, including its officials and employees. The total score as stated in Section 4.0 shall be the basis in determining the amount of the PBB an agency is eligible for. The maximum rate of the PBB for agencies that will receive 100 points shall be 100% of the 65% monthly basic salary of an individual as of December 31, 2021. Please refer to Section 7.0 of MC Number 2021-1 for this matrix. All agencies should submit evidence of accomplishments of performance results, process results, financial results, and citizen or client satisfaction results as provided in Section 4.0 on or before February 28, 2022. Electronic submission, which includes the scanned copy of the official submission and editable Microsoft Word or Excel files for use of the AO25 Secretariat. Ensure that all explanations and justifications for deficiencies are already attached in the agency's submission. Agencies are encouraged to provide information to the AO25 Secretariat on compliance with the agency accountabilities provided in Section 5.0. Head of agencies with the support of their performance management teams should enhance the implementation of their internal communication strategy on the PBB and fulfill the following. Engage their respective employees in understanding the PBB. Disseminate the performance targets and accomplishments of their agencies to their employees through the internet and other means, as well as publish these on their respective websites for the public's information. Set up a help desk to respond to queries and comments on the targets and accomplishments of their agencies. Set up a complaints mechanism to respond to the PBB-related issues and concerns raised by officials and employees of their respective agencies. The head of the agency shall designate a senior official who shall serve as the PBB focal person. For questions and clarifications, agencies may visit the AO25 Secretariat website through www.dap.edu.ph/RBPMS. PBB-related documents can be downloaded through the rbpms.dap.ph/policies-insurances. Agencies may also choose to email us through the AO25 Secretariat at dap.edu.ph. Feel free to visit the AO25 Secretariat Facebook page for announcements and other information through facebook.com/PBB Secretariat. Thank you.